A Filipino-American's works are proudly on display in one of America's most prestigious modern museums. This past weekend, Paul Pfeiffer opened Prologue to the Story of the Birth of Freedom at the Geffen Contemporary at the Museum of Contemporary Art in Los Angeles. For the next 7 months, the MOCA will house Pfeiffer's deconstructed pieces, artistically placed throughout some 30,000 square feet of museum space.
This is a legendary institution founded by artists and a legendary space that's had an incredible history of really important groundbreaking exhibits for decades. So it means a lot. It's a big space to take on for an art exhibition.
The museum's chief curator says Pfeiffer's exhibition is a long overdue one.
I've been following Paul's work over the last 20 years, and it's been riveting to see his work and the importance of his work from that period, from the very beginning of the late 1990s.
Pfeiffer was born in Hawaii and had spent his childhood in the Philippines. He's now based in New York and continues to showcase a mixed medium of art through photo, sound, film, as well as vintage video, and even wood. The immersive experience looks at the fascination of pop culture and sports spectatorship by deconstructing images and even sounds. His vision comes in all sizes, from small LCD screens to a 25-foot model of what a million-seat stadium would look like.
Sports to me is like a way to look at society, not just sports, but like society as a whole. It's something very familiar, and it in some ways it's like it's a form of entertainment, but it's also obviously like an economic generator, and it's something that really brings people together. So in a way it's like a very familiar entry point, which actually has a lot of layers to it. So I'm interested in sports as a way to kind of dig deep into the hidden dynamics of society.
Sporting spectacles make up a majority of Paul's exhibits, and here is one familiar sports spectacle we may be familiar with: the fight of the century between Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather Jr. Very interesting look. Both fighters are fighting solo. Look, it's magic, right? And then if you go into the immersive room, you get to see there's the actual fight itself, and behind the scenes, look at it. So. Very interesting perspective of a major sports event that many Filipinos know. Many more Filipino images and references are sprinkled throughout the exhibit, especially behind this Justin Bieber Santo called Incarnator, which was commissioned by the Geffen Art at the MOCA in 2018. The pop star's image is built like the statue of a saint and has many layers to this artwork. The renowned Filipino master sculptor Willie Layuga Pampanga Province, as well as other Santo makers in Spain and in Mexico, contributed to this installation.
My interest was really like in the tradition of Santo making in Pampanga and Laguna. You know, like to me, this is this kind of woodworking to create religious images is something that carries a kind of DNA, cultural DNA that goes back centuries. 2017, it just occurred to me that in some ways a pop star like Justin Bieber is almost like a saint. And particularly because in 2017, Justin Bieber had a kind of personal transformation where he literally, in front of the eyes of the world, became a born-again Christian and began tattooing his body, beginning with the words Son of God across his chest.
Paul Pfeiffer's exhibit runs until June, with other special events and programs taking place as museum-goers take a look and listen at his world, both small and stadium-sized. Steve Angelus, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.